The trial resumed at the anti-corruption court following the constitutional ruling early this year, which ordered former board chairman of the National Social Security Fund, Geoffrey Onegi Obel, to be tried here. This morning, Obel appeared before the High Court Judge Margaret Tibulia to answer charges of abuse of office and causing the financial loss of over 8 billion shillings. One of the witnesses, Edgar Agaba, a former head of the PPDA, told court how the accused breached the laws when he went into a joint venture without consulting the PPDA for guidance as the law demanded. Agaba also told court that it was wrong for the board of directors to assume the powers of the counting officer when they approved the contract for Mugoya States Limited, a role which was supposed to be done by the accounting officers. Another witness, engineer Patrick Mutenga, told court that they pulled out of the project because of corruption in the process. Obel's trial today followed the dismissal of his petition with costs by a panel of five justices led by Remy Kasule, in which he was challenging his trial at the Kololo-based court as illegal. Obel had urged that he could not be charged with criminal offences under the Anti-Corruption Act of 2009 for offences that he allegedly committed between 2003 and 2005. The former board chairman was initially charged jointly with Leonard Mpuma, former NSSF managing director, former labor minister Zoe Bakoko Bakoru, and businessman James Isabidie. However, in March 2008, the charges against Mpuma of receiving a bribe were dropped after he pleaded guilty to causing a financial loss of 100 million shillings and paid back the money. The charges against Bakoko Bakuru and Isabidie were also withdrawn since it had become hard to arrest them.